Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. A hearty good morning to you, children of the living God. I am Kenson Baptiste from the Methodist Church, Grenada, guiding you into a period of devotion this morning. Please walk with me as we reflect on the power of a gentle answer. Before we go any further, let us submit ourselves to the omniscience of the Father as we bow our heads and our hearts in a moment of prayer. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. Dear God, we remember you as a God of peace this morning. A gentle God, one who is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger and rich in love. Oh, how our hearts leap for joy at the memory of your saving grace. We thank you this morning for your many gifts which you continue to give us, though we are not deserving, for we fail you very regularly. But it is in your nature to have mercy, and on that we depend. This morning we remember your gentleness and your call for us to be gentle peacemakers. Quiet our souls this morning, soften our hearts and massage our tongues, so that from them will come life and not death. In the mighty name of Jesus our Savior we pray. Amen. Proverbs 15 verses 1 and 4 says, "A soft answer turns away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger, and a gentle tongue is a tree of life, but perverseness is in it breaks the spirit." Many times, because of our fear, we lash out at others with anger and harsh words, trying to protect ourselves from a perceived threat. However, as is so often the case, the best way out of a problem is the way that does not always feel natural. The reading is saying to us this morning that in response to someone who may be tempting us to anger, we should choose grace over force, gentleness over fury. Why? Is it because it sounds holy? No. In its practical application, it throws cold water on a brewing quarrel and extinguishes the flame. Brothers and sisters, when we encounter a situation which causes our blood to begin to boil, we should ask ourselves this simple question: what is the objective of my response? Do I want to start a fight, or do I want peace and harmony? Which is better for your mind and your body? I think we all know the answer to that question. Yet many times we choose the wrong side of the coin. I implore you today, as we endeavor to grow spiritually, or even to exist in this world, to choose peace over wrath, and life over a broken spirit. Amen. I pray that the following song will calm your hearts and set us up for a day where we draw one step closer to our Maker. Be blessed.